McVicker, it's done. Don't look like your friend's gonna have much to say to that prosecutor.
Yo, you niggas lost?
Nah, we right here where we wanna be.
Here's a little known fact. The console versions of 50 Cent Bulletproof were some of the best-selling games of last year. It's not hard to understand why. In addition to the game, it also came packaged with 50's tracks and music videos, making it a multimedia package hip-hoppers could not turn down.
Now where the fuck is he?
Now Vivendi is preparing rap's biggest star for his PSP debut in 50 Cent Bulletproof G-Unit Edition. And while the name has remained the same, the game has definitely changed. For starters, the PSP version of Bulletproof plays from a completely different viewpoint. Instead of the third-person over-the-shoulder camera, the entire game is played from an isometric overhead perspective. This gives you a much wider view of your surroundings. The story is the one part of the game that's remained the same. 50's buddy K-Dog has gotten himself into some trouble, and when the superstar rapper goes to investigate, he ends up with the infamous 9 bullets in his backside, and K-Dog is killed.
What you know about K-Dog?
Not one to back down from a fight, 50 must avenge the death of his homeboy and get to the bottom of the situation. While the PSP version of Bulletproof may outwardly look like a hack-and-slash RPG like Gauntlet, there's a good deal of gunplay involved. 50 has an arsenal packed with pistols, Uzis, machine guns, and if all else fails, he always has his fists. Gunplay is governed by a lock-on feature that allows you to strafe around the thugs without the overhead view becoming an issue. The game uses a circular menu system to select your armaments. You simply hold down the button, choose the weapon using the analog nub or directional pad, and then release it. A lot of the mission objectives revolve around taking out mob leaders while tracking down who killed K-Dog. Along the way, 50 collects money, jewels, and health power-ups while mopping up any goons dumb enough to stand in his path. Once an objective is given to 50, the mission essential items and locations are marked on a map so that they're easy to find. While 50's a sure shot with a gun, he has more than one way to clean up the hood. He can use his fists to beat down the opposition, or when things get tough, he can snatch them up and use them as a human shield. You can also pick up just about any item lying around the environment for some blunt trauma action. But probably the most impressive and fun way to take out enemies is the counter kill. These over-the-top moves allow 50 to exact his revenge in the most brutal of ways. With so many different counter kills, you'll find yourself playing and playing just to catch each and every one. No matter how you decide to take down the enemy, numbers will pop up above their heads, signaling how many hit points the attack zapped from their health meter. When the meter hits zero, they're 6 feet deep, and your pockets become even deeper. The money can then be spent at the store to get yourself some new threads, or at the weapons van to pick up that shiny new shotgun you've had your eye on.
Motherfucker, Spinoza was the one who shot me.
While the console versions of Bulletproof are more about the single-player experience, the PSP version gives you that and much more as you can play the game wirelessly with up to 4 friends. With a completely unique take on gameplay that should interest both 50's fans and gamers alike, it'll be interesting to see just how well thuggery and role-playing mix together. We'll find out when 50 Cent Bulletproof G-Unit Edition heats up the end of summer later this month.